Welcome you into week five of the Ken Spark Show. Carson Newman on the road at 22nd ranked Lenoir-Rhyne, and the Eagles fall 52-17 to the Bears. Hello, I'm the voice of the Eagles, Adam Cavalier, alongside Carson Newman, head football coach Ken Sparks. Ken, a highly frustrating game, one of those games where what could go wrong did. How do you sum up the week five loss to LR?
Well, we probably deserved what we got, and we got a pretty good spanking, and we really made a lot of self-destructive plays. Anytime you give up 21 points with a kicking game, you're probably going to get beat. I don't care what you do offensively and defensively. If you give up 21 points kicking game, we got a snap over the punter's head. We got a blocked punt. We got two kickoffs for touchdowns. Well, I think maybe one of them was to the 3.
One was inside the 10.
And then even the opening kickoff, we gave it up for a long one, and we got the ball back on that one. Didn't cost us any points, but cost us an unbelievable field position. And so, I don't know. We're coaching them as hard as we can, but we're just not. We're just very, very self-destructive, and that's, that comes back to me. It's my fault. I'm not getting somehow or another. We got some kids really, really playing hard, and I don't think anybody thinks that they're not playing hard.
Yeah.
But we're just making some. We're shooting ourselves in the head, not in the foot, but in the head. And it makes it hard to overcome. It really is, and it's frustrating to play. I know our kids are frustrated as a dickens, because I think we got great kids, got good hearts. They want to do it right. The majority of them, it was a frustrating day. And the rain didn't have anything to do with it. It was wet, but it didn't have anything to do with it because they play on the same field we play on. And so, maybe we're too concerned about that scoreboard at the end of the field. I don't know. I'm trying to figure it out.
Is it a back to the drawing board moment? Do you take you mentioned the scoreboard? Do you take emphasis off that and more on life to try to teach?
We've always done that. Yeah. We do that daily, and we've always said that's not what we play for, the scoreboard. That we play for our relationships, and so many of them are critical for our future. Our relationship with the Lord, our relationship with others. It's the key to life, and so I don't know. I don't think you don't panic. You don't act like the world's coming in. Because I want to tell you, at halftime, even though right to the last 2 minutes of the half was a disaster. We gave up a touchdown with 8 seconds left, and we were. I really thought we was going to win the ball game at halftime. I really did, because we couldn't do things in my mind any worse than we did the first half, as far as giving up some stuff that good football teams just don't give up. But sure enough, we found other ways to do it the second half. I don't know if our kids believe we was going to win at halftime or not, but I certainly saw it in the eyes of some of them that we was going to win this ball game. But we didn't get it done.
Carson-Newman falls on the road to Lenoir-Rhyne, 52-17. We take a look at the first half highlights after this on the Ken Spark Show. Back on the Ken Spark Show as Carson-Newman falls to Lenoir-Rhyne, 52-17. Eagles drop to 3-2 overall and 1-2 in South Atlantic Conference play. I'm Adam Cavalier alongside Carson-Newman head football coach Ken Sparks. Ken, first half still very winnable, as you alluded to before the break at the half. You're only down 16-3. Yes, the final 2 minutes are a little dicey, giving up two touchdowns, but what did you communicate to the team in the locker room at halftime?
Well, that we just need to go out and eliminate some of those mistakes that we made the first half, and we're going to win this ball game. That's what I communicated, and I thought coaches did a great job making some adjustments, and I, you know, I, let's go get them.
The big play at the tail end of the half, a snap over the head of the punter gives LR good field position at their 30, but the touchdown with 8 seconds left. What happened on that play?
Well, we just didn't tackle him, you know. We just didn't tackle him, and we missed some tackles. And I think for two straight ball games now, we've had over 30 missed tackles. We don't win ball games with 30 missed tackles. And and I'm sure Lenoir-Rhyne had something to do with it too. I know they blocked us very well at times, and they're a good football team. We made them a lot better than they are, and that's what breaks your heart when you're playing against a good football team and then you make them a whole lot better because of the way you play. That's given a double edge that they don't need to have, you know. So two times in my 105 years of coaching that we've had a ball snapped over the punter's head. Two times in my history, and that's something.
That is something.
And woo! Is that an ugly event? You go, did that really happen? You know, and so.
Carson-Newman falls to Lenoir-Rhyne. Eagles down at the half, 16-3, and we take a look at those first half highlights.
I did that.
Ivory and Phillips the slot back. Ivory in motion. The pitch is to him. It's on the ground, still on the ground, away from it. Emmanuel Orange will pounce on top of it, back across the 30, and Carson-Newman has the football. LR botches a pitch left to Christan Ivory, and the ball just skittering along the turf into the backfield. Emmanuel Orange just snaps back, hold is down, Hare puts the boot on the ball, and he squirts it through the uprights. 14 plays for LR to get 3 points. 6:41 left. Second down, six to go for the Bears. Sims takes, runs the option keeper right side, has a hole, the ball's out, and it's free. On the ground, a scrum. It looked like McFadden poked it out. Brandon Ballard was in the neighborhood ready to hop on it. Did he grab it at the 18? Bodies everywhere, and LR does recover it. It looked like Brandon Ballard had a decent shot at it.
You got to kick it here, though. You're at the 6-yard line, and this situation, you got to at least try to put some points on the scoreboard here in the first half. Come away with something after that long drive.
Chance to tie the game with a 23-yard field goal. Snaps back, hold is down, Wise boot on the ball, and he splits the uprights. We're tied at 3 with 6:46 left in the second quarter, thanks to Carson Wise and his 23-yard field goal, route 14 on the play clock. Sims gets back to the line. Patrick behind him. Ivory in motion. Sims pitches it to Ivory. Into the boundary left. Ivory angling to the end zone. Touchdown. Lenoir-Rhyne. Christan Ivory, his 8th rushing touchdown of the season. Goes in from... First and 15 from the 30. Patrick handoff straight ahead. Patrick taking it the distance inside the 5 to the house. Touchdown Bears. Patrick blows up the Eagles from 30 yards out, running straight up the middle.
Those are the first half highlights as the Eagles fall to Lenoir-Rhyne, 52-17. Ken Sparks, still some bright spots in this one. Damian Baker running about as hard as I think anyone I've seen in my 4 years here.
He's given us all he's got, and the growth that kid has gone through has been unbelievable. And he was heartbroken after this ball game, and I hope that, you know, sometimes when we're young in our faith, we forget that the Lord sometimes teaches us through tough stuff. Mm-hmm. And you know, we sometimes we get the mentality, okay, you know, I turn my life over to Christ, and now it's peaches and cream pie in the sky, and nothing wrong will ever happen. And that's just not life. That's not the way it works. And we wouldn't grow if that's the way it was. And so I am so impressed with his growth and what he's doing with himself. And Damon Baker's got a great future.
We take a look at the second half when the Ken Sparks Show returns after this. Welcome back on the Ken Sparks Show. Eagles fall in week 5 on the road to the Lenoir-Rhyne Bears, 52-17. I'm Adam Cavalier, alongside Carson-Newman head football coach Ken Sparks. Ken,
do you have to keep saying that score? You know, can't we just say it once and forget about it?
I'm just trying to remind you so that you get angry for next week. It's motivation.
Okay.
It's a very frustrating game. Second half, certainly things get a little more frustrating. We talked about the snap and the quick score with 8 seconds left in the first half, but in the second half, a fumble on the opening drive, a long run for Lenoir-Rhyne, and then a blocked punt. Bang, 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 and you find yourself down 4 scores.
Yeah, it happened quick, and it happened very, I don't know, just kind of like it, the bomb fell on us, you know, and And of course, again, give them credit. Give you Lenoir-Rhyne credit. They made the plays, and we didn't. We didn't execute. But it was it's an opportunity. You know, it's an opportunity to grow and realize in life that's the way it happens sometimes. You know. I can remember, the fact is, it seems like, in my history at least, disasters have kind of come in pairs. You know, something will happen, and then, you know, and then within a week, something else has happened, you know. And so it's just a great growth opportunity, and and I love our kids, I really do. And I told them that after the ball game, and that's not blowing smoke, it's from my heart. And we're going to stick together, and we'll get this thing done somehow.
You're officially in survival mode now. So playoffs are still a possibility at this juncture. We saw that in 2012 when a 2-loss team ended up getting a first-round bye. How do you use that at this juncture, or do you use it?
Well, we haven't talked much about, you know, next week or week after. We're just too busy trying to take care of today and get today, get better today. You know, and that's been kind of our theme the last 2 or 3 years of just concentrating on today, and especially with a team as inexperienced as this one is. And, you know, I got to thinking coming back home yesterday, you know, from the ball game, I got to thinking about we had 7 guys playing on defense, and before this year had never been on the field for Carson-Newman. Well, maybe 1 or 2 of them for a couple, 3 plays.
Yeah.
You know, sporadically a couple, 3 plays. But the majority, especially the front 7, I think 4 of them had never been on the field, and maybe 6 of them had only been on the field some. And so it was pretty, you know, it's still a growth thing going on, but it's time. Gosh, we're veterans now. Mm-hmm. We're 6 games in, we're veterans. And we got to start acting like it. We will be 6 games in. We're 5 games in.
Carson-Newman drops a contest to Lenoir-Rhyne, 52-17. We break down the second half highlights.
Schaefer in the recovery and rumble by Sparrow. Here's a pitch left side for Ivory. Cuts back. Good blocking, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. Christian Ivory, his 2nd touchdown of the day. This one on a pitch around the left side. And the Bears are in front, 22-3. First and goal from the 3 for DeAndre Thomas and company. Thomas takes the snap. Option keeper right side, and DeAndre Thomas is in. Touchdown, Carson-Newman. DeAndre Thomas, the option keeper around the right tackle, finds pay dirt from 3 yards out. And DeAndre Thomas has his 37th career rushing touchdown. Sims takes, hands off straight ahead. Patrick, a good head of steam, and Patrick dives for the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. Patrick on the dive. Puts the Bears in front 37-10 with a minute 52 left in the third quarter. Handoff up the middle for Patrick, dragging Carson-Newman defenders inside the 20, still on his feet. Patrick bounces it out right side, diving for the pylon, and he's in. 31 yards for Michael Patrick. From its own 35, Suber under center. He'll hand off to Baker on a dive. Baker scrambling out of tackle, still on his feet at midfield, dragging defenders into LR territory at the 45, and finally brought down by Robinson, a 20-yard ramble and run for Damian Baker. Quarter, Eagles with fourth and goal from the one. Suber will keep it with the sneak left side, and he'll squirt into the end zone. Touchdown, Carson-Newman. Ogle actually will put the full boot on the ball and send it back to Ivory at the three. Ivory picks his way forward, straight up the middle, has it bounce it to the outside. Ivory off to the races. 50, 40, 30. Nobody will touch Christian Ivory. Touchdown, Bears.
Those are the second half highlights as Carson-Newman drops its Week 5 contest to Lenoir-Rhyne when the Ken Spark Show returns. It's time for Michael Wattrang to shine his Eagle spotlight, and he puts it on cornerback Jason Williams. That's when we come back. Welcome back on the Ken Spark Show. I'm Adam Cavalier alongside Carson-Newman head football coach Ken Sparks. Time now for our Eagle spotlight. And this week, Michael Wattrang shines it on cornerback Jason Williams.
Junior defensive back Jason Williams was a quarterback in high school. The Fayetteville, Georgia native learned valuable lessons in being a leader as the signal caller and said it was a blessing to come to Carson-Newman.
It's great, man, just being a part of a whole team and just being another puzzle piece in the big scheme of everything. And I just think it's great. You know, I have great coaches that believe in me. All my guys believe in me. And it's just been almost breathtaking, to be a part of something so great.
Defensive backs coach Aaron Hutzel sees the leadership and attitude from being a high school quarterback each day with Williams.
I think the thing with Jason is he's extremely motivated. He wants to be the best at whatever he does. He's extremely competitive. So when it comes to doing technique, he wants to be a technician. He doesn't want to rely just on speed. But you know, whatever he does, he wants to be the best at. And that comes every single day. That's not just something that you know he does every once in a while. He brings that consistency every single day, and that's why he's gotten better, you know, in his junior year.
Junior safety Jerry McLeese acknowledges that Williams takes some of the pressure off of him by being a vocal leader on the field. McLeese likens Williams to a honey badger for his willingness to be a physical corner.
He's a consistent worker. He's a hard worker. He grinds every day. He does the extra work. He kind of reminded me of Tyrann Mathieu because he's small, but he's savvy. He loves to get in and try to hit like your biggest person and stuff. So. We really fortunate to have Jason because he's energetic.
The defensive back position has been among the most talented groups since Williams stepped on campus. It has done nothing but to motivate the junior to improve every day. Hutzel believes that his upbringing as a quarterback helped prepare him for competition.
Well, I think just the thing with Jason is he works hard every single day to get better. Coming from high school, he was a high school quarterback, a very talented kid. He's just gotten better every day since he's been here.
The motivation to improve as a player has not overshadowed what Williams and the rest of the Eagles get to do on a daily basis. The man known as the fastest player on the team sees the value of being a part of the Carson-Newman family.
I think one of the biggest things that Coach Sparks and his coaching staff teaches us is that, you know, it's not just about you. It's not about how many stats you put in the book and this and that, but it's about, first of all, you know, it's about God and what he has planned for you, but it's about, you know, bringing everybody with you, you know, talking about that leader and just getting everybody to the main goal. And whatever the goal is, you know, here we want to win the national championship, we want to win the SAC, but we also want to win life, and I think that's pretty huge. Like I said, it's a blessing, it's great, and I think that's one of the biggest things. It's not about you, but it's about everybody else.
Coach Ken Sparks said that Williams has grown into a leader because he has a heart that's turned to the Lord, saying, quote, "That's the way you become a leader." For the Ken Sparks Show, I'm Michael Wattrang.
All right, thank you very much, Michael Wattrang. Ken Sparks, Jason Williams, one of those guys who
A lot of heart.
Yeah, it looks like he's becoming the heart and soul, that kind of William Alderman role where he's the guy that's firing up the defense.
Well, he's sure trying. He's doing his part, and he's still making a mistake every once in a while, but his heart's right. He's grown a lot, and it's fun to see what the Lord's doing with Jason.
Turn your attention now to the Brevard Tornadoes, Paul Hamilton's club, always tough to deal with what they do with the triple option and arguably a coach who does as much as anybody else in the South Atlantic Conference with his resources. What challenges do the Tornadoes pose?
Well, they're never going to play dead. You know, they're not going. They're going to give you all they got, and you know, they're in a tough situation. They hadn't won a game yet, but they're playing people tougher every week. And so I'm sure after they watch this video, watch this game of Carson-Newman against Lenoir-Rhyne, they're going to say, wow, we can get this guys. And they sure haven't got anything to fear coming in here. So we're going to have to play well. And plus it's, you know, fall break, and that could create some limitations on preparation for a game. And so it's just stuff that's not any different than life, you know. You got, there's some adjustments that you have to do, and you have to make the adjustments and go. And so it's go time, and we got to get it done.
Fun chance to get back into the laboratory of learning and use football as a way to build your life.
No question. And if any of us have a problem-free life, we're probably going to be babes in the way we handle things. And we got some problems football-wise right now at Carson-Newman, that's for sure. And probably the number one problem is the head football coach. And you want to swap this week?
You call the game, I'll coach?
Yes.
You mind me installing a spread offense in a week?
If you got the tools to do it with.
I can make that happen. I've got some recruits that I'll bring in.
Okay. All right.
The NCAA won't frown on that, I'm sure.
No, not, you know, get Peyton to come up and spend a day with us.
Oh, I was thinking Chad and Randy. You got to remember what color my blood is.
Green clad.
Yeah.
Chad Pennington and Randy. That's a pretty good crew right there.
We run the spread. We'll be all right doing that.
I hear you.
Ken, pleasure as always. We'll talk to you after the Brevard game.
Thanks.
That is Carson-Newman head football coach Ken Sparks. I'm the voice of the Eagles, Adam Cavalier. This has been the Ken Sparks Show. Thanks for watching.